The Polish Polar Station from the outside. The Polish Polar Station Hornsund lies near the shore of Isbjørnhamna, inside the Hornsund Fjord. The spot affords magnificent views of the fjord itself and mountain peaks on either side of it. The highest among them, and in South Spitsbergen in general, is Hornsundtind, which rises 1,431 meters above sea level. Right on the shore stands a boathouse known as Banachówka, which is an outbuilding for storing inflatable boats used for transporting people and equipment, flotation suits and other marine safety gear, outboard engines and the like. On one of the corners of the building stands a navigation landmark, which is the UWE1 lighthouse. Located nearby is a local petrol station, or containers with petrol and diesel oil needed for generators and numerous vehicles, including motorboats and snow scooters. Further inland, the first building to catch your eye is the main building of the station, which holds scientific laboratories, rooms for the overwintering team and summer guests, a kitchen, a dining room, storerooms, and bathrooms. In front of the main entrance stand flagpoles. There are always two flags flying from their top, that of Poland, which owns the station, and of Norway, which has sovereignty over Svalbard. The other flags, if there are any, are of home countries of the station's guests. The station's main T-shaped building is surrounded by research infrastructure, as well as various technical and utility buildings. Two satellite antennas ensure that the station has continuous internet access, and although the connection is not as fast as what you may get in Poland, it's fast enough to enable video communication or live streaming. Close by is a weather station containing a range of devices for meteorological measurements, and a little further, two magnetic pavilions and a seismological pavilion where measurements of the Earth's magnetic field and earthquakes are regularly carried out. Not far away runs a mysterious pipeline which ends in a nearby lake. In the summertime, it supplies water to the station. In winter, when all water courses freeze up, the expedition team get their water by melting snow and ice. At the back of the main building, you can find the mechanics workshop and a power generator building. The generators working alternately inside it supply the entire station with electricity. The much larger building next door is a storehouse for construction material and heavy equipment. Inside it, there's also a carpenter's workshop, a waste sorting point, and a waste incinerator. The open space between the storehouse and the station's main building is used during the unloading of supplies, serves as a parking lot for PTS amphibious vehicles and snow scooters, and occasionally also as a football pitch. It's high time we explain the function of the little outbuilding connected to the back of the main building with a wooden bridge. It's a biological sewage treatment plant. Together with the already mentioned waste incinerator, it ensures that the station complies with all applicable environmental protection standards resulting from its location within the South Spitsbergen National Park. The last stop on our tour of the outside of the station is the environmental laboratory, which serves two distinct functions. It's an emergency assembly point, holding a supply of food and clothing necessary for the team's survival while they wait for the rescue services to arrive, and the place where measurements in atmospheric physics are carried out. Mounted on the roof is an antenna detecting lightning discharges, an all-sky camera with 180-degree view which automatically records northern lights and cloud cover, and an air collector for measurements of air radioactivity. The Polish Polar Station Hornsund is surrounded by a spectacular landscape. In summer, the Arctic tundra turns into a lush green carpet of mosses, woody plants and lichens, with blooming wildflowers such as saxifrage, making it even more stunning. 2 kilometers from the station is the terminus of the Hans Glacier, where scientists conduct continuous glaciological research. The glacier is also a top free time destination for anyone at the station. Another attraction is a mountain range with Fuglaberget, or the Bird Mountain. Even though it's only 568 meters high, it towers over the area and serves as an excellent vantage point. The foot of the mountain is home to a huge colony of little auks, with many thousands of breeding pairs. The noise the birds make in the summer carries all the way to the station. A few kilometers west of the station lies the picturesque valley of Revdalen. We are now standing at one of the streams feeding into the lake system of Revatnet.
The material was prepared for the project EDU ARCTIC 2, from polar research to scientific passion, innovative nature education in Poland and Norway, which receives a grant of €240,000, received from Iceland, Liechtenstein and Norway, under EEA funds.